sure glad you could join me today. So today we got something pretty cool over here. We got an 18 by 24 canvas, and what I did was I painted it with acrylic black gesso, and then I let it dry, and then I took some acrylic metallic bronze paint, and then I dabbed it on there with a paper towel, just kind of up there like that. So, and then I let that dry. And then I put a nice thin coat of liquid clear on there, and it's slicked up and it's ready to go. Now it's very important to have a very thin coat, so after you put it on there, go ahead and wipe off the excess with a paper towel. If you get too much on there, your paint run right off the canvas and you have a big old mess. So we don't want that. So set my coffee down and I'll let you know what colors we're working with today. Alright. So, on the palette here, I've got titanium white, Prussian blue, midnight black, dark sienna, Van Dyke brown, alizarin crimson, a little bit of sap green, cadmium yellow, yellow ochre, Indian yellow, bright red, and a little bit of magenta. Hopefully we'll use all of them. Maybe not. But anyway. I thought what we'd do is we'd make a nice little fall scene in the woods. Don't really know how it's going to turn out, but we're going to find out. So let's get started. Alright, so let's go ahead and get started here. Go ahead and take our 2-inch brush, and we're going to go ahead and get into the alizarin crimson. Tap it into the brushes. Alright. And tell you what, we're going to cover this whole area with bronze with alizarin crimson. I think that'll be a good way to start. I don't know what it's going to do, but we're going to find out together. Alright. I think this crimson is going to set a nice tone. That's the what I'm hoping for, anyway. It's going to seem dark at first, but I'm going to try to go for daytime. But I'll show you how I'm going to try to get it to brighten up, but we do that with some magic. Well, no, just adding lighter colors, white, and more opaque things will start pulling the color out, but you'll see what I mean here in a minute. I'm going to go ahead and get this covered up real good. will end up being some of the light that's going through the woods in the distance. And you can already kind of see it start to appear. Just, it's just there. Just by adding a little bit of color. This, well, but all that shiny stuff's going to be off in the distance. So that's going to be adding another dimension of contrast. Kind of like in that video a few back, the Into the Woods video. Same idea, except this time we're going for an autumn scene since, well, it's October and right. Leaves are starting to change and kind of in an autumn kind of mood. A little bit chillier today, but felt pretty nice. Felt real nice, actually. Too bad I had to work. Crimson's a real nice transparent color, so as you see, areas where the metallic bronze wasn't, it still remained dark, but that bronze kind of gave it a little bit of opacity, which is why you can see the color here and there, and made an interesting color. The bronze and the crimson together. I like it. I think it's going to give a little shimmer to the painting. Alright, so let's go ahead and. Oh, there's a hair in that. Get that out of there. Take a sip here. Go ahead and take this Prussian blue. Actually, tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a little bit of this Van Dyke brown. We're going to put it in over there with that lizard crimson. Then we're going to take this Prussian blue. We're going to put that with the lizard crimson. We're just going to mix it up in nice, maybe a little more red in there. In nice. Set up real nice and good. All right. Go ahead and keep on using that same dirty brush. And we're gonna go ahead and get that color on there. That's just Van Dyke brown, Prussian blue, and crimson. We're gonna cover this dark area down here at the bottom with that. Alright, so here we go. We're going to have some water in there. I'm not sure exactly where it's going to be, but we've got to have some water in there. How much water there's going to be, I don't know, but we'll figure that out when we get there. We still got trees to make first. I'm go ahead and make sure this has got plenty on there. do is go ahead and get this brush clean. I'll refill my coffee and we'll move on to the next part. All right, got me a fresh cup of coffee. Oh, that's good. And I got my brush cleaned and we're gonna get ready to do the next part. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this this dark stuff we got here. We're just gonna move it, kinda may use it again, but clear up some space to work. And I'll just slap this guy right over there. Alright. Always good to have a place to work. Alright, so I think what we'll do is we'll start off by taking our 1-inch brush and we're just going to get into the CAD yellow. You know, I'm really glad y'all could join me today. And I do see the comments and I do appreciate it. This is I've always kind of been a shy guy, so this is kind of my way of trying to break out of my shell a little bit by doing the YouTube thing. So I'm going to try and be more engage more on the comments and in the comment sections in the future. I just don't always know what to say. But I do appreciate all the kind words and I want to thank you that for all that. And I noticed I had some viewers from UK and India and some other places around the world. And from here in Indiana, United States, shout out a special hello there to all of you. And who knows, may try to make it out to your neck of the woods someday. There's a lot of places in the world I'd like to see. So, all right, so let's figure out where we're gonna put our light source here. And, we're going to start, let's say our light's going to come through here. We're going to use this yellow, and as we go over this, we're going to kind of start turning this bit orange, and it'll be kind of a neat little effect. But make this our sun, it's going to kind of be shining through the trees a little bit. I'm not going to see the exact sun, I don't think, but, well, you'll see what I mean. Because I don't really know what I mean. But we're going to figure it out together. All right. Figure out which direction we want our light to go. Say we want it to come start right here. And just work your way out. Let's work our way out. Seems a little heavy in some areas, that's fine. We'll blend up, we can blend it out. May I got a little too much on my brush here, but that's okay. Beautiful thing about this technique, you got a little too much in a certain spot, just go ahead and you can pull it, see? You can pull it away. And clean this brush real quick. Okay, take a clean dry brush. kinda blend that out a little bit. Working your way out. Okay, let's brighten that up a little bit more. Back into it with our 1-inch brush, back into the cad yellow. We're gonna bring it down like that. Where we want our brightest area. Take our dry brush again, kind of blend that out. Now it's alright if it's a little bit darker up in this corner here. The light's over here and it's kind of shining down, so for perspective wise, if I can remember how to talk, this would be a little bit darker over here. So, at least that's my theory anyway. We got a little bit. Take our, leave it like that for right now. Let's get a little bit of titanium white on there. Some beams of light there. Shining through. We don't want a defined sun, we just want the light source. Okay. Now let's take our 2-inch brush and lightly just three hairs and some there. Kind of get the brush strokes out of there. You know, these lights are messing with me today. All right. So, let's see here. Let's take our French round brush, that is. And a little bit of Van Dyke brown. Let's figure out where we got some stuff going. Alright, well, maybe, you know, here we got trees back here. Just kind of some indications of some stuff. Okay. Now let's tell you what we'll do. Take some Van Dyke brown. Dark sienna and some titanium white. Oh gosh, I just made a mess. Got a little carried away and I made a mess. Alright, let's sit that down for a second. Oh geez. Where were we? All right. Oh boy. All right, let's put some trees in here. That sounds pretty good. Maybe I don't even know what I want to do. Let's make this a little easier. Go ahead and the brush we were using to blend stuff with. Let's just go ahead and get into this dark color we were using earlier on our 2-inch brush here. And make some nice big old trees here. I don't really know where we're going to put it. Let's see here. How about, oh, we got one right down like that. Oh, nice big fat daddy of a tree right there. There. Well, let's go ahead and get our fan. Okay, let's kind of all over the place here. Let's take our liner brush, get a little bit of liquid clear on it, and well, let's see here. Some black and brown. Zoom that out a bit. Get nice and thin. And we got a few things going on back here. Kind of all over the place today because I don't really know what I'm trying to do. That's what will make it an interesting painting. Alright, so let's maybe we got some bushes down here. Let's see, let's brighten this up a little bit. Let's see, let's take our, let's take our round or oval brush. Okay, let's take a dab of this. Ooh, that's way too much. Let's see, I'll just set that over there. I'll use some of that later. Okay, let's get into, let's get into this yellow ochre. A little touch of the Indian yellow. Maybe. take our clean 2-inch brush, just real lightly, just kind of soften that up a little bit. There we go. All right. And let's go ahead and put some bark on our tree here. We got a little bit of Van Dyke Brown, Dark Sienna, and some Titanium White on here. So let's think about where we've got, where our light's hitting. So let's see this guy. Big mighty tree here. Yeah. I can dig it. This one. Now see, so these trees over here, the other side of the light, so the light side is going to be on the opposite side of the tree, and these ones over here. That's the idea anyway. That guy back here. Kind of tapping it on there, gives a little texture and makes it look like bark. And that guy just comes right off the canvas just like that. Alright, so maybe we got a little bit of
need a clean brush is what I need.
It's a good opportunity for me to clean some brushes. I'll be right back. And we're back. I got my brushes cleaned and took my 1-inch round brush here. Got a little dab of liquid white on it. Maybe I'll go just a hair more on there. Okay, I'm getting into this cad yellow here. Just tap it into the bristles. And maybe start off with get into Indian yellow. There we go. Indian yellow a little bit for this bigger tree here. He comes down like that. Bright red a little bit. Back to our old brush here, titanium white, yellow ochre, and we got a few more. What's going on down there? There we go. Two jobbers off in the distance. Out of there. There we go. Okay. You know what? I think it's time we figured out where we're going to put some water. I think that sounds like a pretty good idea. Looking pretty cool so far, I think. And I hope you think so too. So. All right. Maybe we got ourselves a little babbling brook that comes through here. Maybe say, should we go left to right or right to left? We've been going left. We've been going right to left. I guess we could go left to right. I guess we figure out where our shoreline is going to be. Let me add a little bit of pretty much out of Van Dyke brown on here. Add a little bit more was going to use it. Take some Van Dyke Brown, some Dark Sienna, a little touch of Titanium White, always add a little Lizard Crimson to that. Alright, let's see. Where do we want to put our water? Or shoreline, I guess. Do that afterwards. I'm all over the place. I apologize for that. Alright. Plan B. Let's take a little bit. I know. Take a little bit of liquid clear on a fan brush here. Just a little bit. Thank you very much. Okay, and we're going to get into some titanium white. We're going to add just a touch. Just a touch of the bright red. This ought to be interesting. Just a touch. It's almost like pink. Nice and thin, though. It's autumn colors, so we're going to have autumn reflections. Let's see. Let's put our little stream. Yeah, let's just go left to right. I think I need more white to this. Alright. Thank you. titanium white. Get a little bit more on there. Over here, just gotta have something to hold the water on in place there. Otherwise, it wouldn't know where to go. Let's see here. Take this guy here. Get a few. Thank you. this thinned out white with a little bit of, and let's go ahead and get into some magenta. We'll use our 1-inch brush. Let's see, let's get some interesting. What was on this one? We'll find out together. Okay. I'm liking this, I gotta say, I am liking this. I think this is turning out pretty neat. And oh, I don't know, maybe weird little bushes going on in here. How about that? Well, it's got all sorts of color in it. I like it. Last couple little finishing touches to put on this, and we'll be able to call it a day. We've got a little bit of, dirt. A highlight there. Don't need a whole lot. mix of whatever that is, mostly white and some liquid clear in there, but we're going to use this. Put some water lines up here. That would have been kind of distinguish the edge of everything. Ooh, one got away from me a little bit. It's alright. It looks like it's supposed to be like that. Choppiness up there. Okay, let's see. Pull the line up here. There we go. There. All right. I think I need to do too much more of this. Just add one little I think we have ourselves a finished painting. I'd really like to thank you for joining me today. If you haven't done so already, go ahead and push that subscribe button and like, share, comment, hit the little bell icon as well. And until next time, be good to each other and remember, be creative.